hey, we're Weathers, and this is these are some of our crazy tour stories. One that distinctly comes to my mind, it was on a tour we did with the same hotel. We were driving from Seattle when our photographer at the time was driving. I was taking a nap in the passenger seat. I woke up, noticed we only had 80 miles left till empty, and I said, hey, we should probably get some gas. And he said, oh, no, we're fine. We're fine. It wasn't fine. We kept driving, and we were in the middle of like nowhere, Oregon, with like 20 miles left of gas, could not find any nearby ones. And then we ended up just like finding one. So we started to go down this hill where there was no lights, it was completely dark. And we ended up in this very small town called Huntington, Oregon. But apparently they get people who come there all the time. So they have this guy named Scott Wilson, who helped all the out-of-towners get gas.
Mr. Wilson.
And he had like one hoop earring, a salmon sweater, crazy hair, and like denim overalls. But he was very nice. Put some diesel in our van, like right next to a garage, like car workshop, a playground, and library. But so now we're always very stressed when we get close to running out of gas.
Yeah, we usually felt like 100.
There's a picture somewhere.
Yeah.
His voice was pretty funny too. He forgot about us at first when we called him too. Remember, he showed up like way later. Mm-hmm. He was like, I forgot those guys. Probably the other crazy story we had was we played a Christmas show in Detroit, and we weren't of the age 21 yet, but we had identification to say that we were 21, or at least Cameron and I did. And so I went to the bar, I was having a drink, and they didn't check my ID. And then Cameron came up, and then he got a drink as well. And then the bartender realized that she didn't check either of us, like in that process, like it just snapped in her head. And then we gave our IDs that said we were like 25 or something like that. And there was a cop on site. I was confident enough to say that it was real for some reason, and we got kicked out of the venue.
And Jimmy World had just started, and I was so excited to see him, and then I got a tap on my shoulder saying we're getting kicked out, so yeah. I wasn't very happy. But this one is my fault, so the next one...
this one takes the cake.
Yeah, this one takes the cake for you guys. This was an accident. Your guys' was like deliberate. I lost the keys.
It was an accident.
I lost the keys at Lollapalooza. We didn't have a tour manager, so for whatever reason, I was in charge. And
you're the oldest.
Yeah. And we only had one van key, and I lost it. Still don't know where it went. We played, had a great show, and then I was like the most stressful day ever.
It was a great show.
We searched.
It's our first time
everywhere.
Playing
Lollapalooza. But the bummer was we were helping him find the key for like a really, really long, like hours.
Never found it.
Even our manager dipped out before we stopped searching.
Yeah.
He's like, well, see you guys.
Yeah, and so we were bummed because we missed all the bands that we wanted to see. So.
Yeah.
And we ended up playing with Jimmy World later, so.
And we shared a green room with them in Vegas.
So
we had to talk to him,
hang out with him.
It was deliberate. You were gonna get in trouble.
We knew you were gonna get in trouble.
Order a drink, being like, I feel like getting in trouble tonight.
No, but when you lied to the cop, that's a little different story.
He was wearing a t-shirt. Wasn't a real cop. T-shirt cop.
Dude, he looked like Stone Cold Steve Austin. He was huge. Why would you lie to that? Even if he wasn't a cop, why would you lie to a guy that was
about
big?
To drink the beers.
He was massive. In
Detroit,
he was mad he had to make one phone call.
And in Detroit.
Remember, he's like, I had to call my guy to like search it up. I'm like, cool, dude, one phone call.
It also has.
Isn't there real crime in Detroit?